Hello and welcome to today's video. Today we're finally gonna sit down and I'm gonna show you my eyeshadow palette collection. I've been talking about doing this for a little while and I'm finally getting my act together enough to film this. So if you're new to my channel, you'll notice that things are a little bit weird. I have 33 palettes here with me. I'm showing you all 33 of those as well as the 15 that I have at home. Now the ones at home I took home about a year ago thinking to myself, eventually when we move back to the US, it'll be a much easier move to not have to move big bulky palettes. So I kept some of my palette collection here and then some of it's in the US. Now I will just have to throw some music or something over the palettes that are home, but I hope you enjoy seeing my full collection. I know I'm actually excited to watch this whole video because it's been a while since I've seen my collection like all lined up, but I hope you enjoy it. Make sure you say hello in the comments and let's go ahead and get into it. Okay, as we get started, I did want to show you where I store my eyeshadow palettes. I am going to like pull these out to be able to show you a little bit better, but I do keep them in this little drawer here. Seems to work out pretty well for me. It is getting a little on the full side, so I definitely need to be mindful of what I have here, not taking too much more. But yeah, this is where I kind of store my items that I'm not currently reaching for. And then items that are in Project Pans or that I am using in my Shop My Stash, I tend to stack them up here on top of my little dresser drawer. And then this is like my everyday makeup basket where I will pull one in, put it in the basket if I'm gonna use it that day to do my makeup. But yeah, let's go ahead and get into the actual collection. Okay, for lighting's sake, I've laid out all of my palettes on this table. I'm gonna try to go through these quickly because we have a lot to see here. And then I'm gonna try to insert some footage of things that I have back in storage at home. So I'm just gonna kind of pull randomly here. The first one we have here is the Perfusion Emeralds palette. This is such a good palette for like the cost, especially if you like these tones. I do enjoy the mattes a little bit better than the metallics. Metallics are a little on the thin side, but all in all, really beautiful color story. And I especially love these mattes right here, these like grungy olive tones. So this one is beautiful. Now I have a feeling that I'm going to be using the word beautiful a lot. This is the Night and Day palette by Revolution Pro. Pat McGrath dupe. I love this palette. Not the same quality as Pat McGrath. Obviously you do have to do a little bit more work for this palette, but really, really, really enjoy the color story for this one. Now this next one here is the C Color Fairy Tale palette. This is like brand new to me. I was just given this by a friend. And it's one of the like Too Faced Clover palette, I believe. It's a dupe for that palette. And I have not worn this on my eyes yet, but I am excited to try this out, especially now that we're in spring. And I think that this is just a really fun soft color story with lots of pops of color, which is kind of right up my alley. Next up, we have a little Stila face palette here. It's got some cheek products and some eyeshadows in it. This is the Tan Deep palette. I'm neither tan nor deep, but this blush down here works for me. And I really enjoy the quality of these kind of products. I have taken this one traveling with me and it's pretty nice for that reason. Reaching over here in my grandma's sweater, I have my Beauty Bay Pastels palette. Nice palette in terms of variety of colors. Definitely thin, white-based powders that you really have to kind of pack on versus blend. You will blend them away if you try to blend them. But this one is newer to me, but I actually am kind of enjoying this, and especially paired with some of my Super Shock shadows in my collection. So this one is one that I've recently got, but am enjoying. Now this next one down here, this is the My Little Pony palette from Pure. I had such high hopes for this color story. I thought it was a gorgeous color story. Hate the shimmers in this palette, but I can't seem to let it go because I do still really like the mattes here. So yeah, a little bit disappointed in this one, but all in all, I think I got this for about $9 at like Kohl's. All right, next up, let's move over here to this little stack. This is the Sigma Enchanted palette. Also got this at the end of 2020. This was in my Pan Those Eyeshadows project, which is why you see the pan and that little guy. But this is a beautiful color story. If I'm honest, I don't really love the Sigma like formula. It's not horrible, it's just not my favorite. I like something along the lines of Modern Renaissance or Natasha Denona. These mattes are a little bit dry on me. They can be a little bit patchy. You have to build them up, which also doesn't help with the fact that they can get a little bit patchy. Now the shimmers are beautiful, but I do have to wear them over glitter glue, which again is not my favorite. But all in all, I do really, really enjoy that color story. Okay, this next one is also a newer palette to me. I got it at the end of 2020. This is the Solmone palette from Odin's Eye. This is a Swedish makeup brand, which is part of the reason why I bought it. Beautiful color story. Really am enjoying this so far. I did have to press this back in with my finger. It's falling out. It had fallen out when it arrived to me. And also since then, it's kind of wanted to loosen from the pan occasionally and almost fall out. So be careful. Some of these shadows are super soft and will tend to kind of move around. But all in all, I am really excited to have this in my collection. This purple is insane. Love this green. The rest of it, they're really nice quality, all except for this shade here down here, which is a complete dud. It looks beautiful. I wish it wasn't so like, I don't know what the issue is. Like I rub it all around and you can tell like barely any pigment, but yeah, That's the only disappointment there. Now this next palette is not a disappointment. This is the BH Weekend Festival palette. Love this palette, love the quality of this palette. Really, really enjoy the color story. Now it's not always something that I can wear on its own. I do tend to like pair this palette with other palettes because it's so colorful and it's only got just a couple of like mattes, but I do really love it. And I actually really wanna try more from BH Cosmetics. I've seen so many palettes that have tempted me, but I'm trying to not go overboard with buying new palettes because clearly my collection is already pretty large. So I'm trying to make sure it's like tones that I wear and tones that I already don't have, which is the actual challenge. But yeah, this is a great palette. Okay, this next one here is the Wet n Wild Coffin Break palette. Newer to me, I haven't really worn this much, only a handful of times. I got it the end of 2020. And in the winter and like spring, I just tend to wear cooler tones. So in the summer and in the fall, I hope to kind of reach for this one a little bit more and get to know it a little bit better. All right, this next palette is my NYX Ultimate Brights palette. I've had this for a while. This is one of the first colorful palettes that I ever bought. Definitely not the best quality, but then again, there are a couple shades in this palette that I think is really unique and special. Like, I like these greens down here, I like this yellow, and I love these purples on the end, and I can't seem to let it go yet, but if I do find better, like, shades that are similar enough in a better quality, I will eventually let this one go. All right, I believe now we're gonna start breaking down things a little bit more by formula. First off, we have the Saharan by Juvia's Place. Really enjoy the quality of this palette. I especially love this green up here. Not the most cohesive color story to me. There are a couple like shades in this palette that I don't quite know what to do with, but all in all, I really do enjoy this palette, especially in the fall. And the other Juvia's Place palette that I have is the Nomad. This one is one of my absolute favorites in my collection. I love this color story so much. Such a beautiful fall palette. Also such a good like summer one too. This is just such a well done 9-pan palette. Love this one. Totally was surprised by this one. And this one is definitely one of my favorites. Okay, next up we have ColourPop. I have four currently with me from ColourPop. This is the Honey palette. Such a gorgeous yellow palette. I love, love, love this palette. I'm actually one of those people who likes the pressed glitter formula from ColourPop. So for me, this is like an ideal palette. Like absolutely adore it. Now this next one, the Main Squeeze palette by ColourPop, is not a favorite. I do really love to wear reds, but I find that these reds are a little bit more pink based and they're not my favorite. However, these like deeper reds down here are really beautiful in the fall. So I do still enjoy this palette, even if it's not my favorite red palette that I have in my collection. I do really enjoy it. Okay, this next one is one that is actually one of my favorites. This is the Baby Got Peach palette. Again, I think peach tones are so perfect for spring and for summer, and I love the shade Hungry Ghost up here. Absolutely one of my favorite shades in my entire collection. Such a special shade, can transform so many different looks, and I just think that this palette in general is very well done. I really, really enjoy this palette a lot. And the last one I have from ColourPop here is my Truly Madly Deeply palette. I bought this one instead of buying a couple of different singles that I had my eyes on. I was interested in Poodle, Mr. Sandman, and then also a couple of these like pressed glitters, and it just ended up being cheaper to buy this guy. And I really do like it. It is not quite the color story that I had, I guess what I'm trying to say, anticipated it to be, but not my favorite, but I do really like the palette. It is definitely softer, and it's just one of those things where I feel like I only use it in the spring or in the winter. I don't really think I would use this other parts of the year, and I think that's kind of the biggest tick against it. Okay, let's go through these here. We have two Too Faced palettes, the Natural Matte palette. I know this has been repackaged since this version, but I really, really enjoy this palette a lot. Such a good like variety. We get some cool tones, you get some warm tones, you get some neutral shades. Beautiful palette. And then the other one we have here is the Too Faced Sparkling Pineapple palette. Another really beautiful color story, and I actually really am excited. Like once we ever get to travel again, I do anticipate being able to use this while I travel. Really nice green shade, or it's got that red green duochrome kind of flip to it. And then this shade here is so beautiful, such a chunky shade, but so daggum beautiful. Really, really enjoy that. And so this one, I was lucky enough to get on sale for like 10 bucks, and I really enjoy it. Okay, these next two here, I don't own like more of the same brand, but this is the Marc Jacobs Electric palette. Really, really love this palette. This is the 2019 holiday release. Such good quality. The shades are so pigmented and so beautiful. I love this. I have to just show you this one. Tell me that's not like the most ridiculous silver you've ever seen. Beautiful, beautiful palette. I really want to try more from Marc Jacobs because I really enjoy the formula. And another formula that I enjoy is the Lorac Pro 3 palette. This is such a like kind of a boring color story, very neutral, very monochromatic almost, but I think the quality of the Lorac shades are really nice, and I think that they don't get enough love on YouTube these days, but I do really, really, especially if you have mature eyelids, The Lorac formula is so nice. All right, let's go ahead and do these two dose of colors palettes. This is the Marvelous Mauves, one of my go-tos when I want mauve tones. Such a beautiful like formula, very soft pigmented shade. Definitely gonna get some kick up, but I kind of like that. And I think they're just really easy to work with and very beautiful tones. Then we have the Dose of Colors Fornication palette. Beautiful color story. I love the like uniqueness of some of these shades, although I will say, and I constantly complain about this, that these beautiful glittery shimmer shades do tend to like crease on me if it's a super long day of wear. So that is something to keep in mind if you have oily eyelids. All right, let's go through this stack of Anastasia Beverly Hills. First, we have Modern Renaissance, such a classic. I love the variety of this palette. Get some cool tones, get some warm tones, beautiful berries, nice pops of color. A lot you can do with this palette. One of my favorite ones to travel with in my collection. Then we have the Sultry, which is another beautiful palette. I do sometimes often complain about the fact that these three kind of brownie tones are so similar. Could have switched it out and maybe included a little green or something, and it would have been like a perfect palette, but I love the quality of this palette for sure. Then next up we have the Jackie Aina palette, one of my favorites. Again, I love the color story of this one so much. You can do so much with so many different pops color, red, purples, these kind of like beautiful tones down here. I absolutely adore this palette so much. Then I have this Soft Glam palette. I got this at the beginning of 2020. I haven't given it a ton of love yet. Honestly, I think I didn't really need it since I do love the Modern Renaissance so much. I think if you're someone who is interested in modern renaissance but you don't think you'll use the berry tones, this one's a better option for you. But it's definitely not bad quality. I do enjoy it. It's just that I like Modern Renaissance a little bit more, and I tend to use it or pick it up before I remember to pick this one up. But still great palette all in general. Next, we have one of my favorite color stories of all time, Subculture. I'm just so inspired by the Stagum color story, so much so that I have trouble reaching for it sometimes, which is ridiculous because this palette is not getting any younger. And I really do need to kind of start getting over that, but I do really, really love this color story, especially in the fall time. So this one is just one, again, I get so inspired by. And last up, we probably have my favorite one in my possibly entire collection, but at least at the very much I can say my favorite ABH palette. This is the Norvina palette. I love this palette. You can do so much with it. You get some cool tones, you get some warm tones, you get these really fun pops of like pink and purple. I love this palette so much. If you've seen me before talk about this palette, you know that's one of my favorites, and I just cannot say enough good things about this palette in particular. All right, last up for the items that I have here with me in Sweden, we have the Natasha Denona palettes that I have. This one is newer to me. I have not worn this one on my eyes yet. This was given to me by a friend. This is the Mini Tropic palette. I'm so excited. I've been swatching the mess out of this, trying to get ideas and think about ways that I want to wear it, but I have not reached for it yet. I think I actually will do my makeup with it today. So this one is new to me, but I'm so excited to play with it. Now, next up is the Mini Lila palette. Such a cute little color story. I especially love it for pairing with the Big Lila palette, and I just like this. I know that the quality on this has been, some people love it, some people don't, but I'm one of the people who really enjoy it, specifically I think because I do wear it with the Big Lila palette, and I quite like it for that. And then of course we have the Big Lila palette. Such a beautiful color story. I don't always love that the metallics in this tend to be a little bit more satin than they do like really high impact metallics. I would have liked a slightly different metallic formula, but I have to give it to this color story. If the metallics were just a little bit more of what I wanted, this would be my number one palette probably, because I absolutely adore the color story, and despite it not being my favorite quality wise, I still wear this one so often. But yeah, this one is a really beautiful palette. I got this one on sale half off, so I'm not mad at that palette. Now, if I paid full price for it, I probably would be a little bit more disappointed, but this one is one that I really, really enjoy having in my collection. And then last up is my Natasha Denona Gold palette. This is probably my second favorite in my collection. Such a beautiful palette. A little bit sentimental to me. My husband and I, well, we decided since we couldn't go to Greece like we had originally planned, I asked for this for my 10-year wedding anniversary gift. And it's just, it reminds me of that. And not to mention that this color story is just stunning. Like, it's just jaw-dropping. I love the textures in this palette. I love the quality of this palette. I adore this palette so much, and if it had a little bit more variety, it'd probably be number one, but this one and the Norvina palette, I kind of go back and forth with which one is my actual favorite, but yeah, this one I have to mention because it's so beautiful. Now, obviously, that's everything that I have here. Let me go ahead and insert some clips of palettes that are at home in storage in the U.S. Like a right, that is my eyeshadow palette collection in all of its glory. Please again, make sure you say hello in the comments, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.